Embark on a voyage of discovery with your family with Celestron's best-selling PowerSeeker Equatorial Mount Telescopes. These telescopes come with everything you need to get started with astronomy, including a tripod, a finder scope, two eyepieces, and a Barlow lens, which triples the power of each eyepiece. The equatorial mount is a favorite of amateur astronomers because it makes it easier to track objects as they appear to move across the night sky. Choose the optical tube that's right for you, from the compact PowerSeeker 60 EQ with grab-and-go convenience to the large PowerSeeker 127 EQ with more light-gathering ability. Every PowerSeeker offers great views of the moon and planets. A larger model will provide more detailed views and help you enjoy fainter deep sky objects like star clusters and nebulae. When you're out under the stars, use Celestron's free Sky Portal mobile app for iOS and Android to locate objects in the night sky. Center the object in the finder scope and it's ready to view. As you observe, listen to Sky Portal's audio descriptions for the most popular objects. Happy stargazing.
Ready for a new kind of telescope experience? Unlock the power of your smartphone to help you navigate the universe. Introducing Popular Science by Celestron StarSense Explorer 100AZ. A 100mm refracting telescope that revolutionizes the way you interact with the night sky. It's fast, easy, and accurate. In minutes, you're ready to take a guided tour of the most popular celestial objects. First, dock your smartphone and launch the StarSense Explorer app. Unlike other astronomy apps, StarSense Explorer aligns precisely with your telescope and uses sky recognition technology to pinpoint its exact position in the night sky. Follow the simple instructions, and in seconds, the app generates a list of all the best objects currently visible in your night sky. Select an object from the list and follow the on-screen arrows to the desired object. As you move the telescope, StarSense Explorer recalibrates its position in real time. The bullseye turns green when your object is ready to view and in the eyepiece. It's that simple. StarSense Explorer works anywhere in the world. No cell signal is required. So whether you're in your backyard or a remote dark sky location, the universe is yours to explore.
Meade's new LX85 series features a high-quality, portable, go-to German equatorial mount with AudioStar handbox. The LX85 series is the perfect choice for the cultivated observer and astroimager looking to chase deep sky objects. Used as a standalone mount, or maximize your viewing potential with an array of different optical tubes to choose from. Meade's LX85 series will keep you looking up for many years to come and set a standard for mid-sized telescopes at a great price. The LX85 features a Vixen-style dovetail receiver for mounting observing equipment up to 33 pounds. Coupled with a sturdy build and low-cog servo motors that ensure smooth tracking performance. This stable mount can impressively handle slight load imbalances with ease. With its built-in integer gearing motor drive, you'll be able to track through long exposure using Meade's Smart Drive feature for recording permanent periodic correction. Seamlessly image the best parts of the night sky without having to worry about performing a meridian flip. The LX85 mount also includes an integrated AutoGuider port to readily connect to your AutoGuider camera, making your astroimaging experience easy and straightforward. If these features weren't already enough, the LX85 is compatible with Meade Zero Image Shift Electronic Microfocuser and wired illuminated reticles. With the included AudioStar hand controller, you have easy access to over 30,000 objects that you can view with the simple press of a button. AudioStar's Astronomer Insight technology features a built-in speaker that plays over 4 hours of educational content about the celestial objects you view. With the LX85 series, changing optical tubes is effortless. Whatever your observing style, the LX85 has a scope for you. Choose from a 5-inch achromatic refractor or a 6-inch Maksutov-Cassegrain for lunar and planetary viewing, 6-inch or 8-inch Newtonian reflector for versatility, or the awesome 6-inch or 8-inch ACF models for deep sky views. Meade even offers their Series 6000 apochromatic refractors paired with this mount. The universe is too grand to be confined to one optical tube. With the easy-to-use Vixen-style dovetail, you can now easily swap your OTA and continue exploring the night sky. Capable of handling a variety of optical tubes and equipment, expandable and upgradable, the Meade LX85 mount is designed for you to rediscover the night sky again and again. Whether you are at a beginner level or you're venturing into astrophotography, the LX85 series is the portable and reliable mount to grow with your level of experience. For over 20 years, Meade's ETX series telescopes have provided novice astronomers quality, value, and performance, with each new model bringing enhancements and improvements. The all-new ETX Observer series continues that legacy. The ETX Observer models come in an 80mm refractor, a 90mm Maksutov-Cassegrain, or a 125mm Maksutov-Cassegrain design. These telescopes now feature the AudioStar Handbox controller, which gives you easy access to a 30,000 object database and includes a built-in speaker that plays educational content about the celestial objects you view. Just follow the easy-to-understand LED readout, and the onboard computer will point and track any planet, galaxy, or nebula. Find and observe deep sky objects in minutes. The 80mm and 90mm feature a removable optical tube that brings versatility and customization to the ETX. The ETX 80 comes equipped with a backpack and tripod, making it great for people on the go, while the ETX 90 comes with a hardy carry case, a rigid tripod, and a tripod bag to protect when transporting. The ETX 125 features a large 127mm aperture that marries the portability of the ETX with Meade's premium optics. Enjoy detailed close-up views of the moon and planets, and be amazed by the stunning views of star clusters, nebula, and more. Whether you are hiking, camping, or in the backyard, the ETX observers are made for observing anytime, anywhere. With go-to and tracking capabilities, these are the ultimate portable computerized telescopes.
Step up to Celestron's best optics at an entry-level price point with Cometron 114AZ. Hailed with 50campfires.com Gear of the Year Award, this lightweight, portable telescope is a must-have for camping trips and backyard observing. What takes Cometron 114AZ to the next level? The precision parabolic mirror made of high-quality optical glass. Cometron 114 corrects optical defects for sharp, detailed views of all your favorite celestial objects, from the moon and planets to galaxies and nebulae. Originally designed as the ideal telescope for viewing comets, Cometron 114AZ features a wider field of view than any other telescope of a similar size. Point it at a comet and you'll see more of its dazzling tail. Or observe large celestial objects, like the Orion Nebula or all seven stars of the Pleiades Open Star Cluster, in a single field of view. The large primary mirror gathers enough light to reveal faint details. Cometron 114AZ includes everything you need for a great observing experience on your very first night out: a sturdy steel tripod, two eyepieces, and a star pointer red dot finder scope. When you're out under the stars, use Celestron's free Sky Portal mobile app for iOS and Android to locate objects in the night sky. As you observe, listen to Sky Portal's audio descriptions for the most popular objects. Happy stargazing!
Hello, I'm Ken with Orion Telescopes and Binoculars, and this is the Orion SpaceProbe 2 76mm Altaz reflector. It's a, like I said, 76mm, that's about 3-inch reflector on a simple Altaz mount. And Altaz means altitude, up and down, azimuth, left and right. So this telescope moves very simply up and down and left and right. It's motions you're already used to. There's no polar aligning with this type of a mount. Very simple system and easy to use to move around the night sky. Let me show you some of the features about the telescope, and then at the end I'll kind of show you how to basically use the telescope to get started looking at something in the night sky. Well, the telescope itself features a 76mm reflecting mirror down on the bottom here, well, bottom on this side. That's big enough to get all sorts of great views of planetary and lunar detail. So rings of Saturn come out very easily. The moons are on Jupiter, a couple of cloud belts on Jupiter. If you're looking at the deep sky objects, you'll be picking the brighter ones. This telescope is definitely capable of seeing some of those. So if you were to point this at the Orion Nebula, you'd see some of the clouds and dust and gas up there. Andromeda Galaxy, you'd see a nice little oval structure. Of course, all that's provided that you get a little bit away from the city lights. That really helps when you're looking at the deep sky. There's a vast majority of star clusters that are visible with a 76 millimeter. So something like the Pleiades star cluster will look beautiful. So moon and planets are excellent, and then some of the brighter deep sky objects are well within the range of a 76 millimeter reflector. On the side, you get a couple of accessories. So first of all, you get two eyepieces, a 25 millimeter and a 10 millimeter. So you've got your low power 25 and the high power 10. I hear a lot that people get those confused and they think the 25 is the higher power. It sort of makes sense because it's the higher number, but it works the opposite. 25 is low power, 10 is your high. You always start with something like this to find the field of view, and then you zoom in with the 10 to get a closer look. On the side, you have a finder scope, and this is a red dot reflex sight style finder. So very simple to use. You look through it, you see a little dot floating in the sky, and you just move the telescope around until the dot overlaps with the object that you want to look at, and when you look through the eyepiece, there's your object. So the mount, like I said before, is a little Altaz yoke mount. It just swivels up, down, and left and right. No polar lining necessary like you would on an equatorial mount, so definitely a simpler system. Once you lock down the object that you want to see, let's say you're looking at Jupiter right there, you lock it down here for up and down, and you lock it right over here for left and right. There's a micro motion control rod here for up and down, so you can actually get a little bit finer control by just twisting this knob, and it will slowly raise or lower the telescope to recenter an object. For left and right, you've got a nice long tangent arm here, so you can just move it by hand and get very fine motions just by grabbing the end of the telescope and pushing. So a very simple mount to use for finding things in the sky. In terms of using the telescope, there's really not much that goes into this. It's very simple. You've got your low power eyepiece installed in the focuser. You've got your finder on the side. The knob is unlocked here. Now you can move the scope around, up, down, left, and right. The first thing you've got to do before you can use the scope to find something in the night sky is to align the finder. That's really the one primary thing you want to do. Otherwise, it's really hard to find things. There's a lot of black area around the object that you want to look at. It's a big sky and a small object. So having a finder that's aligned really helps aim the telescope well. So you do that during the day. Find some corner of a building or the top of a power pole, some object that's easily identifiable out there. Point the telescope at it, not using the finder scope, because remember, this is not aligned. When you first attach this, it might look like it's facing the same direction as the telescope, but it's a little bit off. The dot's not precisely calibrated. So find something the hard way. Look through the eyepiece, get the corner of the building, center it in the eyepiece, lock it down, and then verify that it's right in the center of your field of view. Then look through your finder scope, and you'll see the dot. It'll probably be a little bit off. There's two screws, one here and one here, right there. That adjusts the dot of the finder scope. One will adjust it this direction, and the other adjusts it this direction. So play with both of those until the dot's overlapping with the object that you see in the eyepiece, and then you're calibrated. You might have to go back and forth a couple times in case you bump the telescope as you do the calibration, but pretty quickly you'll get that dot aligned, and now you're ready to use the finder to center some object in the sky. And then, since I know this is calibrated, when I look through this eyepiece, it will be right in the middle of the field of view. One last thing to keep in mind when using a telescope like this, if you're a beginner and you haven't really used eyepieces in telescopes before, I do hear this a lot, is how the eyepieces insert into the telescope. So the eyepiece has this 1¼-inch barrel, and it slips into the focuser, and it uses this set screw on the side to clamp it down. I hear a lot of people try to, if they want to remove the eyepiece, they try to unscrew the eyepiece. Well, you don't want to do that because while, yes, you can unscrew the bottom of this eyepiece here, that's part of the assembly process for the eyepiece at the factory, and that you don't want that to come off. So leave it attached and threaded on. It's a slip fit. You loosen this set screw so it's not impinging into the inside ring, and you just slip the eyepiece in and tighten the set screw, which pinches the eyepiece from the side. And then same thing, when you want to remove it, don't unscrew it. Just loosen the set screw and slip the eyepiece out and drop your other eyepiece in. That's all you've got to do. Very simple. All right, well, there you have it. Those are the features of the SpaceProbe 2 76 millimeter Altaz reflecting telescope. You're ready to go out and start viewing the night sky. So enjoy your telescope. Thank you very much. Clear skies.